This was the scene down 694 after St. Paul police say they got a hit on the license plate of this black Mercedes, reportedly stolen in a previous carjacking incident in Minneapolis. That chase stretching from St. Paul to the intersection of 38th and Bryan Street in North Minneapolis, where police say the three suspects ditched the car. At least one of those suspects was a 13-year-old boy whose mother, who didn't want to be identified, says this isn't her son's first run-in with the law.
Absolutely not.
With tears in her eyes and passion in her heart, watching her son sitting in the backseat of a squad car yet again, she says, is just another painful example of why something needs to be done to keep young boys like hers out of trouble while calling on other mothers in the same situation to step up.
We need money to get institutions built to heal our own black and brown children, period. The judges keep letting our sons out because it's the pipeline to prison. We mothers that have our sons with this violent behavior, we need to get together at the table with the people, with the money, the governor, the mayor, and we need to get a solution. I know a solution needs to be together.
She says she knows firsthand the dangers kids like hers face while out on the streets.
I could have been a victim. You know, these are innocent people. I apologize for if my son, if he robbed you, if he stole the car, I apologize. You know, I want to be accountable for this, and I want other mothers to step up.
Finding peace amid the hurt of seeing her child hauled off in cuffs.
I can sleep tonight because I know my son's safe and he's not out committing crimes and he's not out shooting other kids his age that look like him.
From the heart of a mother who, like any mother, just wants to see her kid succeed, she'll do whatever it takes to keep her child and community safe.
I want the best for my son, other kids, and Minnesota. St. Paul and Minneapolis are in shambles right now because of this crime that these kids are doing.
In Minneapolis, Devon Roming, Care 11 News.